Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Quillman, and I'm afraid I've lost my mind. You see, I've been thinking for a while.
Well, hi, guys! Hey, what's up, Quillman?
Edison, how'd you get here?
How'd you get here?
I was here in the first place. You barged in.
This isn't my channel?
No, not at all.
What? That's weird. Did we cross the streams?
Oh no. Oh
never
no.
Cross the streams.
Never cross the streams. It's almost as bad as trying to eat the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
Oh.
Octothorpe reference. Anyway. So I've been thinking for a while. You know, it might be nice to know what our top 10 favorite Pokemon are. You know what I mean?
I do know what I mean. People always ask me what my favorites are, and I had to really think about it because I didn't know either. So,
yep. Well, I guess with me, like, my top three are kind of well known. I've said them a lot, or you can infer them, but the rest of that list, I wasn't quite sure of myself. So, it's been interesting to try and pull this together, and I think it's time I revealed some of these to the people, but.
The world.
You're here now.
Yes! Yeah, and I decided I saw you over here doing a video, so I thought, I'm just gonna come over here, butt my way in, and I want to do a
like
top 10.
Like you normally do, okay.
Yeah, exactly. Because I also wanted to do a top 10 Pokemon video, because, well, I don't even know what my top 10 are until I sat down and did it, so
I thought,
I'll just hijack your video.
Oh, perfect. I'll pay you back later, don't you worry.
Oh, boy.
So, yeah. Since you're the guest here, why don't you go first, Ed?
Fantastic. So let's start off with our number 10s on our top 10 favorite Pokemon. And my number 10 is going to be kind of a random one. It is Sableye.
Ghost Dark with Edison. How Ghost random Dark. Is that, really?
That's true. That does vary me. I like Ghost Pokemon, and I like Dark Pokemon. So I guess that's not too far-fetched. Well, it's not far-fetched at all.
Oh, no.
But something about Sableye, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the typing, I think, kind of cool. Maybe it's cool that, like,
it
you know,
no
before...
Weakness.
Yeah, before Fairy-type came around, it had no weakness. That was kind of cool. Or maybe it's just that kind of, like, you know, gem eyes, kind of crazed smile look on his face. I don't know what it is.
Maybe it's that keen eye ability it has, you know, where it can't lower accuracy.
That could be. That's always
handy.
That's
always very nice.
That is, actually, because I otherwise miss a lot.
this is true.
But I don't know. Something about Sableye just has always kind of rubbed me the right way. Now, one thing that is kind of that's a pro, one kind of con I have about Sableye is I'm not really a big fan of the design of the Mega Sableye. I don't know. It's just like, okay, hey, it's a Sableye, and it's got a really big gem.
Well, I do like the idea that it's the gem on its chest.
Oh, that is true. I could see that. I hadn't actually thought of that.
Mm-hmm. However, it's really weird that when it mega evolves and it's shiny, that gem's green. I don't remember shiny Sableye that well, but I don't think that gem's supposed to be green.
It's the Chaos Emerald. Or the Master Emerald.
Not the Master Emerald. Knuckles the Enchilada. Wait, what?
So what about you, Quillman? What is your number 10 favorite Pokemon?
Well, my number 10, I had to go with a old favorite, Torterra, which was the final evolution of Turtwig, which, because I know you don't have that much knowledge of Gens 4 and 5. Turtwig was the fourth generation grass starter.
I do remember seeing, I do, off the top of my head, know what Torterra looks like, thankfully, because we're both doing these lists blind. We don't know what's on each other's list.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, Torterra is that turtle thing with, like, a tree on its back.
Oh, that's right. Torterras.
Yeah, Torterras. Yeah, see?
I
you
forgot
know
about that. No, Torterra was actually the first Pokemon I ever got to level 100. And was the first time I ever was able to get a starter through a Pokemon game. More on that later.
Cool.
Besides, that stab from Earthquake is always fantastic, and I believe its hidden ability is Shell Armor, which negates critical hits.
That's nice.
So yeah, a lot of really good things going on there. But the problem with Torterra is it has a lot of weak points. Now, yes, it's a grass starter, and that gives it, you know, three or four right off the bat. It's got fire, it's got flying, it's got bug, I believe it has poison. But that double weakness to ice. Oh no. No. And then there's an ice type gym leader. Then there's an ice type gym leader as the seventh gym in the region.
Ooh, yeah, you don't want to use
real pain. However, that's followed up with an electric gym, so I guess that works out.
I guess that balances.
Very well. What about your nine?
So number nine on my list, now I'm already breaking out the legendaries because that's just 9 through 1 are all legendaries.
No. Oh no, he's one of those people.
Number nine on my list is Deoxys.
Deoxys.
Deoxys, Deoxys. No,
I've heard of the Deoxys. X and Y axis, but the Deoxys?
Yes. X, Y, Z axis, DX,
Axel?
Axel? Oh boy. So yes, Deoxys is one of my favorites. Number nine, actually, in fact. I don't know what it is. I like the idea that it's a legendary from outer space. I actually think that's original, and you don't see that. I mean, they did that a little bit with, like, Clefairy, and obviously a few Pokemon they kind of do that outer space thing with, but not that many.
Is that Umodine on a UFO? No, it's Deoxys on a meteorite. Nice try.
Exactly. So, that's just something I really like about Deoxys, and it's cool that it has different forms based on different kinds of types and such.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, I gotta be honest, the Deoxys battle in Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire is just epic.
Okay, you so know? I know about this, but I've not gotten to it yet. I still have yet to beat a Hoenn region game.
Oof.
Yeah.
The battle, the music they do for it is really good.
I cannot wait to hear this because I am a big fan of music in video games normally. I mean, that's why I love Kirby games so much.
Right.
That and they're fun.
Right.
So, I'm looking forward to this, provided I can get there. Watson's been kind of a pain in the butt. And speaking of electric types, my number nine is Luxio.
Luxio!
Do you know what a Luxio is?
I know what a Luxio is.
Very good.
That's pretty Luxio for me. Bad puns.
Be gone with the Lux of you. Luxio is actually a very interesting Pokemon that also has a bit of a backstory with me. Whereas Torterra managed to get me through, you know, three different games, that Torterra that reached level 100 was one of my original Pokemon to beat Red. Luxio was actually the highest level Pokemon the first time I beat a Pokemon game. And
really?
The reason for that, well, excluding the legendaries, of course, but the reason for that being, I was actually playing for my brother and he deleted his starter. Whoops!
Oh no!
And I just kind of took over after a while.
That's so tragic.
Very tragic. But, you know, Luxray's pretty solid. Luxray's a pretty solid Pokemon. It's not got that good of a move pool to complement its stat distribution, but it does have the Intimidate ability, which is very nice. Or it could have Rivalry, which allows it to boost its attack whenever there's an opponent of the same gender.
Okay.
So, yeah, that's actually pretty nice.
That's a pretty cool one.
Mm-hmm. Also, it's a lion.
That is true. It's an electric lion.
It's an electric lion that can see through walls. I kind of expect there to be a Mega Evolution in Gen 7 for it.
You know, that actually would look really cool.
You know what? When we're done with this, we should do a video on things we want to see in Gen 7.
That would also be really cool.
That would be really cool.
So are we moving on to number 8 now?
I guess we should. We've kind of got nothing else to say right now.
All right, so number 8 on my list is actually the first and only. Now, my first and only one on this list from Gen 6.
Oh, really?
Yep, and you also notice that there are zero Pokemon from Gens 4 and 5 because I haven't played
any
of these.
Again, you don't know those Pokemon too well.
Right! So mine are all from either Gens 1 through 3 or this one Gen 6 Pokemon.
Alright.
And the one Pokemon from Gen 6 that made the cut is, drumroll, Aegislash.
Somehow, A, I'm not surprised it's a ghost, but B, I'm surprised that it's not Greninja.
You know? Okay, so X and Y hold a special place in my heart because that's the first Pokemon game that got me back into the game after 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
And my first starter was Froakie. So I thought about Greninja, but it, I don't know. I never really got that much of an attachment to Greninja.
I can agree with that, though I'm definitely enjoying Greninja in Smash.
That's true. I don't really enjoy fighting against Greninja in Smash, but
that's gonna be fun.
But Aegislash, now, in that first playthrough, again, first time really sitting through playing a Pokemon game in 10 years,
oh, yeah.
One of the Pokemon I caught fairly early on was a...
Honedge?
What is it? Yeah, Honedge. And I used it all the way through, the game. It was on my team. And I really enjoyed it. So I have that kind of personal attachment for that first playthrough after 10 years.
Beautiful.
And also, I just like the... I like the concept. It's a really cool that it has a ability that lets it like switch attack and defense modes. That's really cool.
Yeah. All it requires is knowing that move, King Shield.
Right. I like its design. I think it looks pretty cool. It's a ghost type, but it's like a ghost controlling a sword and a shield. I like it. Just everything about it just really does it for me. And in the little bit of competitive battling I've done, Aegislash has always been on, like, any competitive battling attempt of a team I've made.
What's really interesting, though, is if you attach a Eviolite to a Doublade, it doubles that defense stat, and it's already got ridiculous defense.
Oh, boy.
That is fun and competitive.
That sounds fun. I might have to
give that a shot. Yeah.
Yeah.
The only problem is you don't have that, you're not allowed to actually do that switch. That's the only problem there.
That is true.
Well, my number 8, let me take you back a little ways. Take you all the way back. Roll back the rock to the dawn of time. Sorry. let's not go there.
Oh boy.
That's a little too far back. Now let's go back to 2013, huh?
Let's go back to 2013.
Yeah, back when I got started with, doing my YouTube work. You know,
doing the tubing.
I started off playing Pokemon games, recorded with a webcam, and, well, about that time, it was Generation 5 still, and Black and White 2 were they out? I don't remember. I think they were out at this point.
Those are during my dark years, so I'm of no use to you.
No, they weren't out at this point. They weren't out at this point. It was just Black and White.
Back in the days when it was all black and white.
Yep.
Simple, clear cut,
No, it was Pokemon Black and White were the most recent games, and they had been doing the events for, the mythical Pokemon.
Right.
Well, I did a couple videos pertaining to the two that had been released in 2013, Keldeo and Meloetta.
Okay.
And Keldeo, I was not that big a fan of. Yeah, it's a water cult, it's water fighting. I'm not too big on fighting types, but I love water. But part of what I was doing was trying to get form changes. Oh yeah, this was during Black and White 2, wasn't it? It had to have been for the form change. Man, my memory is garbage.
Well, it's better than my absence of...
There you go, there you go.
That's my dark ages.
Mm-hmm. But, Keldeo is based on... Keldeo is part of the Musketeer Quartet, based on the Three Musketeers.
Okay.
The other Pokemon that was released and had an event was Meloetta, and that's my number 8. It is
really?
A Pokemon based completely on music and dance. It was one of the first, 20 videos I ever uploaded.
Wow.
But more importantly, that tune... I'm stuttering a lot. That tune that's associated with it, which is also its signature move known as Relic Song, is one of the most beautiful pieces in Pokemon to date.
Really?
Oh, it is amazing. Like, seriously, dude, you have to play Black and White and Black and White 2 at some point. They're awesome games. But, and it was part of the generation that introduced the actual most Pokemon into the series. So
I am looking forward to it.
Yeah, choose Black and White first, you'll learn to love a lot of Gen 5 Pokemon. That's why so many of them are on my list.
Nice.
But no, Meloetta is just one that's always stood out to me, partially because I have such a strong affinity for music.
Very cool.
It's also got the signature move Relic Song, which will change it from its normal psychic special setup to its normal fighting physical setup between its Aria and Pirouette form.
I love Pokemon that can do like changes like that. That is really cool.
Yeah, and to think it all started with Gen 3.
Yep, goes all the way back.
Cloud. Alright, so, what about 7?
Number 7 on my side.
Lucky number 7.
Let me take you way, way, way back again.
Oh, see, farther back.
You were talking like all the way back to 2013. Let me take you back to 1998.
Oh, I barely remember that. I was 2 years old then.
We got a Gen 1-er here, and number 7 on my list is Scyther.
Really?
Yeah! I have always liked Scyther.
I don't know, like, something about it always bugs me.
Oh! I thought my puns were bad. But yeah, Scyther is one of my favorite Pokemon, always has been. I think, honestly, a lot of it was as a kid, because I would have been like 8 years old when Pokemon was coming out, and as an 8-year-old kid looking at this like big giant bug thing, it's got wings, it's got swords for hands, really cool. It can't learn fly, but you know, that's my drawback to Scyther is it can't learn
only
fly.
Only drawback to Scyther.
That, and if it gives you hugs, it's kind of deadly.
Oh, one of the best things about Pokemon Heart Gold and Soul Silver is you can turn back and talk to your Pokemon, right?
Yep.
If you have a Scyther and it pokes you in the stomach, let's not go any further with that.
That is the drawback. But yeah, Scyther has just always been one of my favorites. I like the design. It looks really, really cool. You know, I look at Scyther and the word cool is just what comes to mind. Mm-hmm.
I'm actually okay with Scyther. It's an interesting design on what was admittedly a really cool Pokemon.
Now you see, I like Scyther okay, but I don't know, I feel like particularly those little pincers that he got, it was kind of a downgrade from those really cool like sword arms that he had.
Though to be fair, they have eyes.
Okay, that is pretty cool.
They look like they have eyes, so they do mimic kind of like a normal insect would.
That is true. I like the steel typing on Scyther, but ultimately, my vote's got to go for Scyther.
Oh, I understand completely.
So what's your number 7?
You're going to laugh at this one. My number 7 is Zubat.
Zubat?
I'm not kidding.
Zubat?
I am
Zubat?
Not
Zubat?
Yeah. Look at it, it's so cute.
You're right, I am laughing.
Yeah, I figured you would. Zubat's actually one of the surprisingly good Pokemon that, you know, you'll come across and just go, why are you everywhere? It's not the only one. Tentacruel is actually really good on its own as well. It's very defensive. But Zubat, you know, it couldn't learn fly for a very long period of time. And it took till we got the second generation's final evolution of Crobat for us to really get something good out of Zubat's line. But at the same time, it's a lot of work to get to, but it's so worth it. If I ever want an actual challenge in a Pokemon game, one of the things I immediately think, let's get a Zubat.
Okay.
It's overly hated for being so common, but you know, after you get it to learn Bite, it starts not sucking.
That is true. I could see Crobat, but Zubat? Weird. Yeah. You're blowing my mind here, man.
Good. I told you I was crazy.
You are crazy.
Mm-hmm. But no, Zubat, I just think it's a lot more adorable than the rest of its evolutionary line. Part of the reason I first picked it up, I'm not going to lie.
I can see it.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, there are problems with Zubat, you know? It does take a lot of effort to actually get it trained. In Pokemon Go, which has been very recently released as of recording this, it's not really the best either. It's hard to come by, and it can only evolve into Golbat, which is good, but not as good as most of the other things people can find. Though, at the same time, this is the highest any poison type will ever get. Although, again, Gen 7 has introduced some very interesting new Pokemon, so we'll see.
You will see.
So how about number six? After number talking six. About Generation 7, let's go back.
Number six. Now we're finally going to start seeing, I've already got a legendary on my list, so now it's time to put a starter, because that's what every top 10 should be full of, legendaries and starters, right?
Well, I've already got two of them on mine, so.
So my number six, I was looking at the wrong one. That's not until five. Spoilers, sorry. So
don't
number six, number six on mine, I've been noticing a lot of ghost types in my list so far.
You're breaking up with a psychic type?
Nope, I'm breaking up with another ghost type, but it's probably not the ghost type that you're expecting.
Mischievous.
Number six on my list is Shedinja.
You know what? You're right.
I have always loved Shedinja. I thought the design is kind of cool. Like, it's... I love the design. I love the concept. Just like, okay, cool. It's
shell,
like...
shell, yeah.
Which is really a neat idea because,
I like
you know,
nice little angel halo it has on.
Yeah, you know, it's really cool. Like, I love the design. I like the Pokedex entry is creepy. Like, anyone who looks into the back is rumored to have it steal your soul. Like,
so
that's creepy.
What you're saying is that most Pokemon players who train Shedinja have no soul.
Right. That's actually why it's on my list, because it took my soul, and now I am...
Insert joke about you being a redhead. just kidding.
So I love, and also I love its Wonder Guard ability. Like,
that can be really powerful. It can be.
Right. Like, I mean, obviously it's a glass cannon to the extreme, but even outside of using it in battle, I love the concept of it. It has one hit point, but it can only be hit by things that's super effective.
Talk about a one-winged angel.
Right, exactly. There's so much I love about Shedinja. The concept, the abilities it has, there's so much I like about that Pokemon that it had to go up on that list.
I understand. It's a good thing Skill Swap won't work with Wonder Guard. Can you imagine a Sableye with Wonder Guard?
Yep, that'd be...
That would be the most terrifying thing.
It'd be unstoppable and among my favorite Pokemon. Mm-hmm. So actually, what about you, number six?
Oh. You were saying something about putting a starter on your list, and you said that was a little too soon. Not so with me. This is another starter.
Oh boy!
This is the grass starter from Generation 5, and is the only starter I've ever used every single time I have the choice to. Snivy! I'm sure you know a lot about Snivy.
I've seen some Snivies.
Yeah, you've seen some Snivies. So there are a lot of things that are really interesting about Snivy. First of all, it is the fastest starter of the set, and it was, at this point, it is the third fastest starter of the bunch. It is...
Interesting.
It was originally second only to Sceptile, which is the grass from Generation 3, which I'm sure you well know. But Greninja also outspeeds both of them.
Interesting.
Aside from those three, it's always the fire starter that's fastest.
Interesting.
I bet you weren't aware of that.
I wasn't, although it makes me like my fire starters that much more.
This is true. I'm very surprised, spoiler, just in case people actually thought about this, Typhlosion is not on my list in any way, shape, or form. I don't know.
What?
Yeah. I had a feeling it'd be on yours anyway. Snivy is interesting. It's the one Pokemon, it's the only starter Pokemon I've ever chosen over any others in its generation. Like, not even Torterra or Cyndaquil have that notification.
Wow.
And honestly, I can't say anything about Gen 6 as starters because I've only chosen once. But I've chosen five different times with the Gen 5 starters, and every time it's been Snivy.
Snivy or bust.
But even though it's fast, here's something I don't like about it. Even though it's fast, it's the defensive option, which is also weird because A, it's a grass type, and B, it's kind of got low health. Not only that, but one of the moves people will normally put on it is Leaf Storm, which will lower your special attack by two stages, which is pretty bad.
Ooh, yeah, that does sound... It sounds like it's got, a very interesting set.
Well, here's the reason Leaf Storm is so common on it. Its hidden ability is Contrary. Do you know what that does?
Remind me.
It reverses stat changes.
I had a hunch you were gonna say
yep.
that.
Yep.
That now, is really cool.
That's a problem for me. Normally I'll play Snivy with Coil, Leaf Blade, some other physical attack, and Flash, because I play more towards accuracy and evasion. But that setup is very, very solid. It boosts the attack and defense. It allows Leaf Blade to do even more damage on top of the stab. And, you know, I'll normally go with, like, Aerial Ace because it never misses, or I'll go with, you know, Aqua Tail because it has 90 accuracy, but I'm using Coil, which boosts my accuracy.
Right.
So, a lot of good choices there.
Very interesting.
Snivy takes a little bit of serious effort to play well.
But it sounds like it pays off.
Oh, it can. But all starters can pay off, right?
That is true.
Right?
That is true. Well, I hope you enjoyed the first half of our top 10 favorite Pokemon video. The second half of this video, where it's going to show our absolute best of the best favorites, is going to be over on Crazy Quillman's channel. And I'll have the link for that down in the description. So be sure to check that out to find out who reaches number one for each of us. Also, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button so I know that you enjoyed it and that you like maybe seeing more of this kind of stuff. And also, don't forget to hit those comments and let me know what you think of our picks. Maybe even tell us some of your favorite Pokemon. Anyways, go over, check out the rest of Quillman's channel, and I will catch you later, everybody.